This is the first time I tried to, you know, tear down one smartphone. To dismantle, okay, to tear down this phone, you don't need a very special tool. Actually, you just need three things, okay? So it's already on your table. The simple screwdriver, nail, and the one small tools. First, I think we need to open the back cover at the bottom of the screen, and then you try to, you know, just press it hard, okay? And then the phone will be open in two pieces. Okay, so you can see the back cover is actually the metal body, so you can feel, right? Cold. And then let's talk about the battery. So if you really want to have the big battery, I think you need to really, you know, have some design to be able to put the whole battery inside. Okay, but before that, we need to take out the batteries. Okay, after you finish that, you are able to get the battery out. This is a 5000 mAh battery, okay? The other thing we need to do is actually the motherboard design, we need to change a little bit. But normally the main motherboard is slightly bigger. Maybe, so our motherboard is around 2/3 of the normal motherboard size. So you can have the space for your battery. If you watch closely, okay, in the back cover of the phone, there are some dip. Okay, and also there's some connector from to connect the main motherboard and the sub motherboard. This is the FPC, okay, we call it FPC, so inside. But in order, because you know the battery while charging and using, it will bulge. So you need to have a space for it. If you are greedy about the small form factor, but you don't leave the space for the battery, then it will become very dangerous. Okay, then let's take a look at the motherboard that's on the top. Okay, this is the main board. Okay, the main board. Okay, then let's first take a look of a few connector. Okay, so the connector that I point out here is the connector to our LCD screen. If you look at it, on your left hand side, there's one small metal body that is covered by metal, okay? So this is where normally when you talk about the digital spec, where is your CPU, RAM, okay, and the storage. So all are in this small metal space, okay? So this model, we have the octa-core CPU, okay, and then with the 3GB RAM and 32GB SSD. And then the other part, the other half, okay, it's the SIM slot, but this one we support the hybrid SIM, so you can put two SIM, and also you can have a hybrid SIM to put either the SIM card or the micro SD card, up to 2 TB. Okay, so this is the square part, where is your CPU, SSD, RAM, and also SIM slot. Okay, then let's take a look about the camera. So camera, I think you can see visible is here. Okay, this is the rear camera. Near the rear camera, did you see two dots? Okay, one is in white color, one is in orange color. And then, in terms of a camera, okay, this is 13 megapixel camera, support the face detection, autofocus, and with our Pixel Master technology. Let's take a look about the front camera, then we can take out the motherboard now. Okay, there's one more connector, so you need to take it out. And then more or less, you can take out the motherboard. Okay? So this is a small thing, motherboard. Okay, so you can imagine how technology goes. You still remember the motherboard is maybe 5 times, 10 times size of this, but now it's very small. Okay, we have a 8 megapixel front camera, okay, with a 2.0 aperture and 85 degree wide angle. Okay, so and support the beautification mode and the HDR mode, everything. And then there's one more thing, I think it's about the antenna, okay? There are two connectors here, this is the connector to the antenna. So one is here, one is here. So we have two antenna inside, but you might wonder, where's the antenna? On the edge, did you see something in silver color? That is a little bit different. This is the antenna, okay? This is called a P PDS technology, so print direct structure. Okay, and then there are two antenna. One is the Bluetooth and the Wi-Fi. Another one is you can consider it's more like a diversity antenna. What does it do? It's because later I will introduce, because the main antenna for the signal for your 3G, 4G, and then calling is at the button. Okay, but when you hold the phone, it's in this direction, right? So we might need another antenna on top to support the signal, to make sure that your signal can be better. And then we have a two voice receiver. One is at the up, one is at the button. Okay, because then we can support the noise reduction. Okay, so the button, the first thing is beaker. The black color you see, okay, but before you do, you need to first take out another screw. This is the speaker. Okay, so this is not the traditional speaker you are aware of. Not the, you know, two circle. Okay, this is a speaker. The first thing, I think you see a very big light silver. Okay, on the motherboard. This is the vibrator. Okay, and then you see another two list pin. Okay, three pin and one pin. Left hand side and the right hand side. Okay, this is the connector to another antenna. So that I just talked about. Then where is the other antenna? You take out your back cover. Okay, so you see one part is black. So this is another antenna. So this antenna is our 4G. Okay, so we have also support the VoLTE. This model also will support the 4VoLTE and the Cat4. And then let's do the last part, is take out this sub motherboard. Underneath, this is the fingerprint. Okay, so this is the fingerprint that we can support the 360 degree. You can also take out, you can take a look, because when you take out, you can see that there's a button. Oh, by the way, since I take it out, although it's not easy, so the proximity sensor, what I talked about, actually your phone, you can also do it, it's like this size. So support the premium, you know, sleek metal body, 2.5D glass. Okay, 5.2 inches IPS display, 5000 mAh battery. Okay, 8 megapixel camera. Yeah, where is it? Oh, this is back camera, front camera. Okay, and then 13 megapixel back camera. Okay, fingerprint scanner, 4G LTE. So the antenna is here. Okay, and then the RAM and the CPU is here, 3GB octa-core CPU. Okay, and then dual microphone, noise cancellation. I hope with this, we give you a different way of understanding one model. For me, it's also very interesting, because while studying this, I also get to know even more. I hope you enjoy it. Later, I think, because after you do that, it's a mess. Okay, so don't say that this is an ugly model. We have the ready machine there.
We got a teardown hands-on experience. We got to know what is the innards, and not just that, we also put together the phone back. So that was a great experience, something which will stay in my mind for a long time.
Specifically regarding this particular smartphone, I think the battery, because you know, for such a powerful battery, I think that the battery inside this phone is so slim and so lightweight.
The basic technology that goes into it is actually similar to what you would expect from a really high-end smartphone. The antenna designs over here, the audio output, the battery life, everything all contributes towards a really unique user experience.
I think it's going to be a wonderful phone because it has a smaller screen size of 5.2 and 5000 mAh. Definitely this is going to be a killer for Asus.
I'm really looking forward to making this my primary driver soon. And I'm feeling that given the demand for premium looking but value for money devices, that is prevalent in India now, this device is going to do very good.
So it was a pretty amazing experience, and good thing is I could reassemble it successfully and I could boot it up.
ASUS should have more events like this.
And I'm looking forward to using this as a daily driver in the near future.
Thanks ASUS, and it was a great experience.